of the chapter 100 dresses to, and it is page number is 78, or it's 70, page 74. Overall comprehension is also let's see. Page 74. You have to write these questions also in your notebooks. So, first of all, let us start. Page number 74. First question, what did Mr. Pentronsky's letter say? So, what did Mr. Pentronsky's letter say? Mr. Pentronsky here refers to whom? Wanda's father. Okay, so Mr. Pentronsky has written a letter to Miss Mason in which he has mentioned what he has mentioned. What he has mentioned, anybody can? Yes, in which he has mentioned that Wanda and her brother would no longer come to school as they have been shifted to or as they have shifted to a new city or to another city where no one is making fun of their names, as number of people they have such kind of long names there. Okay, so actually his letter, it was a complete description, or it is giving an indication of the reason that why Wanda as well as her brother, they both have been withdrawn from the school. Okay, next, afterwards. Second question, is Miss Mason angry with the class or is he unhappy and upset? He is angry with the class. And then is she unhappy or upset? She is upset. Okay, she is upset. She is upset with the kind of behavior that was being faced by Wanda. She thought that the fun has gone to that extreme that they were forced to leave the school and forced their parents to let their children withdraw from the school, and ultimately they have been shifted to another school, and it is just because of this reason she was upset. And this kind of upset nature, how it was shown? By how? This was shown when she adjusted her specs, blew some air over them in order to clean them. That was just a thought process that was going on in her mind, and she was taking time how to acknowledge the class about Mr. Pentronsky's letter. Yes, she wanted to see also. Next, how does Maddie feel after listening to the note from Wanda's father? How does Maddie feel after listening the note from Wanda's father? Yes, she was conscience-stricken. She was having the feeling of guilt that she has done really wrong. Okay. Moreover, when Wanda was not coming to school, she was also feeling that this kind of behavior should not be faced by her. She wanted to stop Peggy. Right? She wanted to stop Peggy. Okay. To make fun of her. And ultimately, when it was finalized, or it was, you can say, confirmed by the note or through the note of Mr. Pentronsky that Wanda and her brother, they have been withdrawn from the school, it was really a great, you can say, jerk for her. She faced, and she felt a great jerk, and ultimately she was not able to concentrate after that in her work also. She wanted to stop. She wanted to meet that girl again. She wanted to meet that tight-lipped girl again who's standing among the crowd during the recess or during the break in the schoolyard, and she wanted the other girls not to behave in this manner with that girl. What does Maddie want to do? Yes, the same next question is, what does Maddie want to do? What does she want to do? She wanted to apologize. Yes, she wanted to apologize of her misbehavior, and moreover, she also wanted. Okay, she also wanted that she should tell Wanda also that she would not face this kind of behavior further again. And moreover, she also wanted Peggy to stop making fun of any other child. She resoluted herself also that if this kind of behavior will be faced by any girl at any time, she would simply stand up and would say great no to this and would not let anybody face this kind of behavior that Wanda has already faced. Right? So the next one is, yes, what excuses does page number is 76 now. Move to page number 76. So on page number 76, question is, what excuses does Peggy think up for her behavior and why? What excuses she was thinking? Okay, so Peggy, who is little bit of carefree nature, she felt bad when she came to know that Wanda has left the school, but it is not to that extent that she would be engrossed in that feeling only, right? What she thought, she after some days she has forgotten about Wanda also, and moreover she is not feeling guilt to that extent as Maddie was. Okay, so what she was thinking that when she's asking her how many dresses you have, she is getting the idea of the various dresses, and she is thinking that it is just because of her asking again and again how many dresses you have that she is able to win the contest. Right now, clear? So what are Maddie's thoughts as they go to Boggins Heights? What Maddie was thinking as they were going to Boggins Heights? Yes? Yes, Bhumika, you can speak.
She was feeling very ashamed as she was also repenting for not stopping Peggy for behaving badly with Wanda.
Yes. So Maddie, who was deeply moved with the withdrawal of Wanda from the school, she wanted to go to Boggins Heights. As she along with Peggy has gone to Boggins Heights, she was again and again thinking of that tight-lipped girl who was not giving any kind of reaction. She is always standing in the crowd and just, you can say, answering the questions that how many dresses she has. She used to say that she has 100 dresses and all lined up in her closet. So her mind was, you can say, mainly occupied with the thoughts of Wanda only, okay, and how she could reform her behavior. She was trying every possible way to meet her and in order to reform herself, but that was just her bad luck that before she could be able to reform herself, Wanda has gone from the school. Next question, why does Wanda's house remind Maddie of Wanda's blue dress? Why does Wanda's house remind Maddie of her blue dress? Yes, because when they entered Boggins Heights, as Peggy and Maddie entered Boggins Heights and they have entered Wanda's house, the backyard, it seems to be shabby but clean. It was not so well maintained. It was unkempt, or it was in unkempt condition. And this reminded Maddie of Wanda's blue dress, which daily she is wearing while coming to school. It is often not properly ironed, but of course it is clean. So she is making a comparison of her blue dress with that of what? She is making a comparison of it with that of backyard. What does Maddie think hard about? What important decision does she come to after that? Yes, Bhumika, give the answer.
Yes. Yes. Ma'am, she thinks that she should not be mute specter. If anyone, like for example, Maddie thinks about not to be mute specter anymore, that she had been in the case of Wanda. She promised herself about not letting any injustice happen to anyone, even if she would have to lose her friend,
yes.
Peggy.
So what she was thinking, she thought hard again, and finally she has come to a conclusion. So what conclusion she has come to? She has come to the conclusion that Dilpreet, what was going on? She has come to the conclusion that she should not be a mute spectator when Peggy or any other girl, they would be making fun of any other child, and she would always protect the child. And moreover, what she thought after that, yes, she should, if Peggy would ever behave in this manner with any other girl, she would simply say great no to that. Although she would be able to lose what? She would be able to lose Peggy's friendship. But even at the cost of Peggy's friendship, she wanted to save the rights as well as save the children from being bullied and ultimately from being harassed in this manner as Wanda has suffered. Okay, so Wanda has suffered a lot. Okay, it is just because of that great extent that she suffered that ultimately she left the school, right? So this is what she has resolved herself to, that she would stop of any kind of, you can say, happening around, right? So next is page number 79. Come up to page number 79. Again, oral comprehension check is there. What did the girls write to Wanda? What did the girls they write to Wanda? Okay, yes. Okay, they is that she has won the competition. Okay, so sit down. The girls, they were, as both the girls, when they have gone to Boggins Heights, but they were not able to find Wanda's family, finally they thought to write a friendly letter to Wanda Pentrovsky. Okay, in this letter, they thought that they would inform her that she has actually, but before all this, actually they wanted to write down that she has actually won the competition and how beautiful all the drawings were, or how beautiful the drawings were that she has made in the competition. Okay, but ultimately they were not able to portray exactly their feelings as they want, and ultimately they have without writing sorry, they wanted, or they started up in a friendly manner. So what did they write? They wanted to inform her that she has won the competition and all her drawings were really appreciable, and how she is doing in her new school, and whether she has found new friends in the new school, and how is the new teacher in her new school, right? So actually, what was the intention of writing a letter? What was the intention of writing a letter? Actually, they wanted to feel sorry. Reason was that actually. Okay, but it was only their conscience, their ego, which was not letting Peggy actually to write sorry. Okay, but the main reason of writing a letter was exactly the same, to feel sorry. But how they ended up about telling the competition that she has won the competition, and ultimately to tell her that her drawings were very beautiful, and finally they ended up asking that how she is doing in the new school and how are the new teachers and the students there. How did the girls know that Wanda liked them even though they had teased her? Yes. How did the girls? Yes. Yes, exactly. Okay. The girls, they knew that that Wanda liked them though they had teased her. First of all, it was from the letter. okay, from the letter that they had received, okay, that Wanda had received, they have sent the letter, and ultimately, Wanda, in spite of writing a reply back to the girl, they have written it to Miss Mason, okay, in which she has answered all the questions asked about her new school. She has told the teacher that she is doing well in the new school, but actually her new teacher does not equalize her. Moreover, she has also mentioned about her drawings that she has made, green one with red trimmings. It should be given to Peggy, and the other blue one, it should be given to Maddie. And the final blow for the girls was that when they have come to know that when Maddie, she was focusing on the picture which was affixed onto the wallpaper in her room, and through her blurred tears, she has come to know that it was only her face that has been drawn in the drawing, and it was, you can say, she thought, and she came to know that it was exactly her who is being displayed in the picture. And moreover, when Peggy also come to know, Peggy has seen her picture, it was only her face that was being displayed there. So from this, they have come to know that she really liked them, and it is because of liking only that she has drawn their faces over the drawings. Okay, that she has drawn the pictures over the drawings. So, see the next question. Thinking about the text. Which one? Was she right? No. Peggy or Maddie, how do you know? This we have explained side by side when I told you that what they have written. The question is, did they get a reply? No. But how they get a reply? She has written a letter to Miss Mason. Who was more anxious for a reply? Okay. Question is left. Yes. Who was more anxious to get a reply? Maddie was more anxious. Why she was more anxious to get a reply? Because she? Because she was deeply moved by the kind of behavior that was meted to Wanda. Okay, she felt really bad at heart. She was really feeling broken also more because of this kind of behavior that was being faced by Wanda. And it is just because of this reason that daily before she was unable to sleep. Okay, as she was unable to sleep, and moreover, what she is getting, she is daily in her dreams delivering speeches about Wanda and to protect and how to protect her. So all the thoughts, all her, or you can say her complete mind, it was occupied by the thoughts of Wanda and Wanda and only Wanda. Throughout the day, also she is thinking of Wanda, and moreover, she is also not able to concentrate. Okay, in her studies while she's studying in the class also. Okay, and it is only she who has thought first of all to go to Boggins' side. So it was Maddie who was more concerned about Wanda's reply. And how do you know this? We have told. Okay, so now coming up to thinking about the text. First question is, why do you think Wanda's family moved to a different city? And do you think life there was going to be different for their family? Yes, Bhumika wants to give the answer. Let us listen. Yes, Bhumika.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes.
Ma'am, Wanda's family moved to a different city due to the insulting behavior of students towards Wanda and her brother, as they were having a unique name, and the other children teased them because of their unique name. So they moved to different city that was going to be different because people there did not have such a narrow mind and would not tease them because of their name or status.
Yes. So we can say that Venda's family had moved to a different city because of the daily insult, or daily, you can say, to be daily picked up by other students, okay, of their children. Because Venda and her brother also, maybe, they were facing this kind of behavior. They were facing the insult just because of their unique name or the long name. And ultimately, her father, when it was excess of everything or it was height of everything, his father has thought to move to another city where people are not so narrow-minded, okay? That they would make fun of having these kind of long names, unique names, as he has also mentioned in his letter to Miss Mason also, that there in the big city, people are not narrow-minded. They have many people, they have such long names and no more fun there. From this point, we have come to know. Okay? Yes. Next one is, Maddie thought her silence was as bad as Peggy's teasing. Was she right? Yes. So the main thing, just one thing is that if you commit a crime, you are a criminal. But if you are a mute spectator to watch it without speaking against it, then you are also considered as criminal. And it is even more, you can say, and it is more biased, okay, that when you are not able to speak for a crime. And this situation was exactly of that Maddie, okay? This was really of that of Maddie, okay? Because what she thought that she knew that what was being done with Venda was absolutely wrong. That she was suffering daily from insult. She was suffering from this kind of fun-making behavior in the schoolyard, not only by Peggy, but as well as by the other girls who were standing, making a circle around her. But ultimately, she was a mute spectator. She was not able to speak anything. And this is just because she knew that she was wrong, and she was daily tormented in her mind, in her thoughts also. Okay? This is the reason why she was not able to concentrate in the class. Okay? She was not able to solve her mathematical sum. Moreover, she has thought to write a letter to Peggy in order to stop her from this kind of fun making daily. Okay, but ultimately what has happened? She has not mustered up her courage. She was not able to gather up her courage to speak against Peggy, as she was afraid that she would lose Peggy's friendship. Okay, so it is just because of this reason that she has turned out to be a mute spectator, but ultimately her mind was not at rest. She was not at all at peace with her mind. She was feeling broken at all the times. Her mind is always thinking of Venda. And when Venda has left the school, she is always thinking how to make contact with her so that she could reform her ways. Okay, but ultimately what has happened? It was her bad luck that Venda has gone forever from Boggins Heights. And moreover, when she was not able to find Venda, then what she has decided? She has decided that she could stand up against any child or Peggy who would make fun of any other child, and she would not let anyone face this kind of behavior as it was faced by Venda earlier again. Right? Next question is, Peggy says, I never thought she had the sense to know we were making fun of her anyway. I thought she was too dumb. And mean. Look how she can draw. What led Peggy to believe that Venda was dumb? Did she change her opinion later? What made Peggy? Yes, Kanishka wants to answer. Yes, Kanishka.
Yes, ma'am. Peggy observations that Venda didn't have the sense to know that she was being made fun of and that she was too dumb were based on the fact that the Venda never reached to Peggy's arrogant taunts. Instead, she chose to ignore them by remaining quiet and by remaining quiet, it was not because she was unintelligent and dumb, but because Peggy's mocking taunts regarding 100 dresses made her firmly resolve of completing 100 dresses designs for the contest.
Okay. So to some of the points I agree. So first of all is, what led Peggy to believe that Wanda was dumb? Peggy was daily making fun of Wanda. Daily in the school year during the recess, all the girls were standing around Wanda and they were making fun of her. What they were asking her, how many dresses she have. Okay. And to this, Wanda is giving only single reply without speaking any other word that she has 100 dresses all lined up in her closet. She is not at all speaking any other word. She is always seen as a tight-lipped girl by Maddie. So this shows her patience. Okay. This shows her patience and her, you can say, her own, you can say, resolution, or her resolution in her mind that she is, although she is not having those 100 dresses, but she is very happy with the ideas of those 100 dresses that she is daily perceiving in her mind. Though she is daily coming with her one faded blue dress, by wearing her one faded blue dress, but that ultimately what it means, it doesn't mean that she is a dumb character, or she is not at all, you can say, feeling anything bad for what kind of behavior is being shown to her, or if she is picked up daily in the schoolyard by other girls to make fun of. Okay, so this shows only her patience, her resolution of mind. And did she change her opinion later? Yes, her winning of the contest has made Peggy to change her opinion later, and it is just because of this reason that earlier she thought that she was too dumb to speak anything, but ultimately when Wanda has left the school, Peggy came to know that she was also feeling really bad. She was also having the same feeling, and because of which she has left the school. So this made Peggy to change her behavior about Wanda, right? So you can also say that Peggy, who was even the smartest girl in the school, okay, or in room number 13, even she was not able to judge her feelings correctly and accurately. Okay, so even she was not able to judge her feelings. So what important decision did Maddie make, and why did she have to think hard to do so? Yes, Bhumika. Speak out.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, Maddie decided to go to Wanda's house with Peggy to apologize and amend for all that they had, all that happened. But Wanda had left her house with her. She felt bad because she thought of herself as a coward who did not stop Peggy to insult Wanda. So she decided to raise voice against injustice and bullying by next time if she saw that.
So she thought that she should stand against all type of bullying. If anyone is going to face this kind of behavior, that it is only she who would stand against Peggy, and she would not be afraid of losing even Peggy's friendship. This was the decision. And why did she have to think hard to do so? She has to think it hard to do so because she thought that maybe in this line of thought, maybe she would be the next victim, or she would be the next target of Peggy, as she is also not so rich as Peggy was, and moreover, she is also wearing hand-me-down clothes of Peggy. Okay, so it is because of this reason she thought again and again of his decision, and she also knew that by doing so she would lose her friendship, and she was afraid of it earlier, but later on she was not. Okay, so this is all about the discussion that we have done, and tomorrow we will continue with the same discussion with some extra questions also.